Camilla Jackson here from Back to the Movies. We are here to talk about late phases today, and we have the fabulous Lance Guest
fabulous,
with us.
Fabulous, fabulous.
Dolores!
Tell me a little bit about the film. I mean, it's a werewolf film and it's got practical effects.
It's a werewolf film with practical effects, which is kind of the most sort of challenging thing about the whole thing. There's no, as far as I know, there's no CGI, and it's most of the werewolf sequences are, all the werewolf sequences are all, you know, real fur splitting out from real, you know, shirts and real, you know, nails coming out of hands and, you know.
Goodness. Well, watching it, it reminded me of things like American Werewolf in London.
Oh, yeah.
It had that great old school effect.
Yeah.
And was it actual people in suits running around as the tall?
No, they were actual werewolves. No, they were. I believed you. Yes, there were people in costumes that were designed by this great the great Rob Kurtzman, and
who was responsible for things like Army of Darkness,
yes.
Baba Hotep,
yeah,
legend. In the film, you look quite a bit older.
Pretty bad, yeah. Well, I'm supposed to be a geezer. I'm supposed to be an old man.
Yes.
And they didn't do a lot of, you know, real heavy age makeup because you can't really get away with that anymore.
Yeah.
Mostly by the way they were, the way they shoot things and HD and all that stuff. So they're like, no, you're fine. I was like, I'm not really that old, but now you're fine. So, you know, I wore a couple of shirts and, you know,
you just sort of had a sickly pallor about you.
Yeah, they can make you look pretty bad.
Yeah.
You know, just like they can make you look good, they can also make you look pretty bad. Yeah. So I look pretty bad.
And Nick D'Amici, who played the lead,
yeah,
he also was playing a bit older as well.
Absolutely. And he had a couple of things that were, you know, that were, he's not as old as he appears in this as well, but they grade him up a little bit. Nick's terrific. He's such a great actor and great writer.
Smell you, son of a bitch.
It's quite an interesting concept, really. I mean, who would think to have a werewolf story based in a retirement village?
Yeah.
What were your initial thoughts when you first got the script?
It's kind of perverted, you know? I mean, it's very unsavory to think of, you know, these, like, old people just all of a sudden having to deal with werewolves. And it's like that first scene. There's a first attack scene, which is pretty grisly, you know.
Yes.
It involves an older woman, and it's not something you see every day.
No.
I guess it just sort of adds to the sort of getting under your skin kind of thing that horror movies are after.
The first attack scene was truly terrifying. The bit with the dog doll.
Yeah. That was the first time I literally was scared reading the script. Like, I was reading the script and I'm just not in it, and all of a sudden this image of a dog door and this huge nose coming through the dog door was, as it was described in the script, just scared the daylights out of me. I just thought that was, you know, just really it was just like as a writer, he really achieved his goal with the audience as the reader, you know.
Yeah, and then the knocking on the door.
Yeah.
Do you think maybe the writer loosely based the script on the story of the three little pigs?
I'm
very
sure.
Similar.
You know, maybe.
Do director Adrian Garcia Bogliano, this was his first English-speaking film.
First film that, he did in English, because he's Spanish.
Yes.
And he's his films have been in Spanish, in Argentina and Mexico, and, you know, but...
What was he like to work with?
He's a very, you know, shy, sort of unassuming kind of guy, but I think he's a terrific horror movie director. I'd seen his other films, and they really... They scared me. But yeah, they just called me up for this thing, and I really had no idea who the production company was, and they just called up my agent and said, we want him to do this part, and I read it, and I'm like...
So there was no audition process?
They wanted this. I did go on tape, you know, for, yeah. Like, you know, how do you respond to this material and stuff, but I think they told me they were interested in... From the beginning, but I think they thought I was older than I actually am.
How dare they?
But, you know, that's the breaks.
Nick DiMicci's character is quite stern, quite gruff.
Yeah.
Is he like that?
No.
I mean, he played it so realistic, so believably.
Well, he's a good, tough guy. Nick is right, a really good, tough guy.
I really enjoyed the film, and I love the effects, and it's so rare
it's
these days.
It's pretty fun, yeah. That part of it is pretty fun, you know? And
yeah.
So, we'll see. Like I said, it's brand new to me. I shot it about a year and a half ago, and I just saw it about 2 hours ago. So
me too.
There you go.
Well, it's out now. It's downloadable on VOD, on iTunes, Amazon as well.
Amazon, yeah. You know, it's all on the website.
Great. Well, you can download it on iTunes. Check it out, because it really is fun. It's fun.
Yeah.
And the werewolves alone are just... beautiful, I think.
It's pretty, it's the real art, you know? It's the real, like, the old school way of doing things, you know?
Well, hopefully it's a sign of things to come.
Yeah.
More of that. Well, thank you so much, Lance.
Thank you.
That was great. And check out Late Phases, available now.